Thank you. Now I would like to call Kanwal, Jalil upon the stage for speech. Kanwal, Jalil.
It talks about humanity, but whenever someone talks about Indian occupied Kashmir, I see screens and curfews everywhere. Whistling and counting human bodies everywhere. Human pets everywhere. People dividing their beloved ones. Sons, orphans, and daughters waiting for their fathers forever. People of Kashmir dying and children of Kashmir crying. Whenever someone talks about Indian occupied Kashmir, my mind throw all the talks of the so-called international champions into a dustbin. They claim themselves to be the most powerful weapon against our brutality, ferocity, immorality. India's crimes against humanity are reported by more than dozens of the international organizations, including the extrajudicial killing, torture, rape, murder, disappearances, long detention without charge, the drying and the destruction of the properties. Indian security forces are burning the houses of the innocent Kashmiris with the explosive materials. Prolonged, sensitive and the merciless beating to the sensory parts of the body during the COS sale, which is the clear evidence of the India's crimes against the humanity into the Indian occupied Kashmir. Kashmir media reports stating that India is using the chemical weapons in the grab of the curtain and search to hide its crimes from the international community. India's fraud to the humanity with the rise of the Hindu nationalist Bharatiya Janata Party has deeply alienated its Muslim minority. Indian security forces, including the Indian Army, CRPF and BSF, have been accused and held accountable for committing the swear crimes against the humanity into the Indian occupied Kashmir. Research scholar Mazamil has stated that India is committing the genocides of the Kashmiri Muslims to quell their uprising. Seema Kazmi says that it is used as a weapon of the war by the state. 2010 US State Department stated that India has carried out the extrajudicial killing of the suspected insurgents in the Kashmiri civilians. These atrocities, these ferocities, the genocides, persecution, executions, operations, repressions and aggressions carried out by the Indian security forces and the butcher of the Gujarat Narendra Modi are converting this beautiful land into the hell. Religious freedom violation has greatly increased in the Indian occupied Kashmir, but the international ambassadors of the religious freedom are silent. World has considered the 20th century the bloodiest period of the global history. One of the examples of the bloodiest part of the earth is the Kashmir. About half of the million soldiers stationed here in the now Kashmir is reaching to its violent tipping point. The 2018 has been deadliest in decades for the occupied Kashmir, with a recurring violence claiming about the 600 lives. The death toll include the 250 freedom fighters and the 150 civilians. The majority by the occupation forces, including the 6-month pregnant lady in the Kakapura, the person with the intellectual ability, school-going girls, college students, farmers, laborers, professors. It is shocking. About 21 people are killed in the Indian occupied Kashmir during the first month of the 2019. Ladies and gentlemen, the use of the pellet gun was banned in the Spanish region of the Catalonia in 2014 after the 7 people were blinded by their use in the Barcelona. But unfortunately, Indian security forces are using these pellet guns against the Kashmiri people unabashedly, unjustly, inhumanly, barbarically. I wonder if the murder of the Jewish community by the Adolf Hitler in Germany was a crime against the humanity. Then why the murder of the Burhan Mazafarani, Shabir Malan Wani, hundreds and thousands of the people per year in the Indian occupied Kashmir is not the crime against the humanity? Why the heinous use of the human shield and arming the major lethal Gugi, who dehumanized the Kashmiri young men by tying him with his jeep with the chief of the army staff recommendation left road is not the crime against the humanity? Why the use of the pellet gun, which was designed to capture the plane, the flight against the Kashmiri people, is not the crime against the humanity? Why, Mr. President, why making the life of the Kashmiri civilians hell by not allowing them to go to their paddy fields and orchards is not the crime against the humanity? Why converting the beautiful Palwoma district into the human graveyard in tragedy after the Indian self-planned Palwoma attack is not the crime against the humanity? My heart cries when I see the people burned in their houses. May I stop thinking when I see the innocent children killed by the barbarian Indian army. May I stop thinking when I see the women raped in front of their families. Peace has gone. Ease has gone and the happiness has gone from my Kashmir. My mothers, my sisters and daughters have been raped, killed and dehumanized by the Indian security forces. Ladies and gentlemen, Article 7 of the ICC highlights its focus on the war crimes against the humanity, and Article 8 of the ICC highlights its focus on the war crimes. Both these articles have been strictly violated by the India and ruthless Nazis-oriented policies into the Indian occupied Kashmir. One of the examples of the such violation is a 18-month-old Hiba Jan who lost her right eye due to the brutalities of the Indian security forces. Ladies and gentlemen, JRL said India has unleashed a naked against the Kashmiri youth. Whoever tries to raise the voice against the brutalities is silenced either by the means of the ruthless torture or by the means of the repression. Many times Pakistan called the global human rights organizations to take the notice of the atrocities carried out by the Indian forces into the Indian occupied Kashmir. But the international community remained silent. Pakistan is still ready to host the meeting and want the solution of these inhumanity acts for the dialogues and the talks. Many times Pakistan tried works in the talks, but then nothing worked out because India didn't show a positive response to solve the conflict. After the murder of the youth in the Palwama district, the Malaysian Conciliation Council of the Islamic Organization first time showed the concern about the silence of the international world over the atrocities carried out by the Indian security forces into the Indian occupied Kashmir. India must be dragged into the International Criminal Court for this inhumanity act. Kashmir is not the part of India. It is the part of the Pakistan. The majority of the people living into the Indian occupied Kashmir are the Muslims. They want to live their peaceful life. They want to live freely in their homeland. They don't want to be the part of India. They want to be the part of the Pakistan. India should stop this inhumanity act as it will not give anything except the further rebellion and the hatred. Despite the many years of the occupation, could not persuade Kashmiris to accept the Indian rules. Kashmiris have not surrendered, nor they ever would surrender. We salute their persistence to stand their ground for the freedom and justice. Thank you very much.